since before recorded time. It had swung through the universe in an elliptical orbit so large that its very existence remained a secret of time and space. But now, in the last few years of the 20th century, the visitor was returning. The citizens of Earth would get an extra Christmas present this year as their planet orbited through the tail of the comet. Scientists predicted a light show of stellar proportions, something not seen on Earth for 65 million years. Indeed, not since the time that the dinosaurs disappeared, virtually overnight. There were a few who saw this as more than just a coincidence. But most didn't.
Hey, Regina. Regina, give that thing a rest, will you?
In a minute, Mel.
Look, I don't pay you to do that kind of stuff around here. Regina, I want you to clean everything up so we can get out of here in time to watch the comet.
Everything's cleaned up. Damn!
I want you to take this flashlight and walk the house.
Aw, Mel, they throw things at me.
Who cares? Walk the house.
Have you ever been hit with dots, Mel? Milk duds? Those things hurt.
Oh, how are you, sir? The refreshments are right over there. Thank you. I don't want those weirdos cutting up the seats, you understand?
Okay. Placing Reg in third place. Yes. Reg. Third place. Wait a minute. Somebody named DMK in sixth place? When did this happen?
Look, don't be an overachiever. You'll fit in better with your age group, okay?
This is really annoying.
Regina, look this way. Regina, look at me. Read my lips. Flashlight. Walk house now.
Okay, man. Let me take this for you.
That's great. They go to profits. And listen, stay out of the projection booth and stay away from Dupree. I'm gonna fire that guy someday. He's been doing to me what he's been doing to her in the booth.
David! That was a scream.
You're right. I'm gonna check it out. You stay here.
I'm talking about a mint-condition print of It Came From Outer Space. In 3D, man. Yeah, right. Tres Dimensiones. Look, you know as well as I do, you got film freaks that go down on you for a bootleg print of that. $100? $100, right. Something wrong with the phone here? Did I hear you say $100? Look, $100 isn't gonna get it this time. Because I'm gonna have to spend the night in here waiting for you to bring the print back. Think I'm gonna miss this comet thing for a lousy $100? Okay, 110's a little better, yeah. Hey, Reggie, here's the deal. You leave, I let you in the back door. Okay, I leave, you let me back in melting so everybody's done.
Larry, do you know anybody named DMK?
No. Oh! No, you gotta have the print back by 6 in the morning.
You know, if we spend the night in here, we're gonna miss the comet.
It's not like you can't see it on television anymore. All right, hey, get your guy here in an hour.
Yeah, well, maybe I want to see it for real, okay?
Hey, television's real. Television's very real.
So what do you say? I'll give you $15.
Are you kidding? We spend the night in here, we end up making it, and you give me $15? Do you know what that makes me look like?
Reggie, I'm not giving you $15 for making it with me.
Okay, well, just so we have that straight, okay?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, you'd be worth a lot more than $15. Everybody knows that.
The first Earthlings to see the effects will be in Newfoundland, or Newfoundland. This is expected to begin at 2:04.
Hey,
that's
Sammy,
Pacific
Sammy.
Standard Time. An interesting sidebar to this story is the fact that all telecommunications seem to be out in that part of the world. This could have...
Hello? Samantha, you sound pissed.
I just had it out with Doris once and for all again. She wants me to, like, haul chips and dips around for a little comet party.
Yeah, well, speaking of Doris, look, I need your help. Tell her that you know all about this field trip that I'm going to take, okay, with my science class. We're going to go to the observatory to watch the comet.
She won't go for it.
She'll go for it. Just tell her, okay?
Okay. Doris, Reggie's on the phone. She's not having car trouble. She's gonna be out all night with her science class at the observatory. I know all about it.
Yeah, hi, Doris.
What's this about a science class, Regina?
Well, you want me to do better in science, don't you?
I want you home in 5 minutes after you finish work. If you want to watch the comet, you can do it here.
Look, Doris, like, I'm 18, okay? And I can watch the comet wherever I want to watch the comet.
Here, Samantha, you and your sister share a lot of secrets. I want you to share this one with her.
If it were up to me, I couldn't care less what she did.
But if your father makes it back home without some Sandinista blowing his brains out,
he's gonna hold me responsible for any kind of trouble you two girls get into.
What we have here is a chain of command. The major jumps on me, I jump on you.
Did you get that?
Okay. Now, are you going to join the party?
Join the party for what, Doris? So I can watch Chuck from across the street stick his hands down your pants? I think that's something Daddy should know.
Chuck's a nice guy. He's certainly nice to be with while Daddy's down in Banana Land.
You were born with an asshole, Doris. You don't need Chuck.
Looks like a real nice crowd we have out here tonight.
Hey, where have you been? You're gonna miss everything. It's from the store.
Oh, kids. I'll never marry another man with kids.
In 1910, Halley's Comet returned. And everybody thought they were going to die then. What's that?
Look!
You want to know what bugs me about all this?
What?
Well, I'm always afraid someone's gonna see us, you know?
See us how? There's no windows. They can't see through walls.
Well, Superman can see through walls.
Not these walls. They're made out of steel. Used to be a fire law.
Superman can see through steel.
No, it's one thing he cannot see through.
That's lead, you nerd.
Lead?
Yeah. I mean, Superman can see through steel like it wasn't there, even.
Huh.
Larry!
Well, I guess I'm the only one who's not Mary? Outside watching the meteor shower. I just might put the radio station on autopilot and sneak out myself.
I've been waiting by that door for the last 30 minutes and that pinhead hasn't brought the film back yet.
Oh, give the guy a break. I mean, people are late sometimes.
No, something's wrong. If he screwed that film up, we could all be in a lot of trouble. I'm gonna go over there on the bike.
Oh, geez, don't I get an egg McMuffin or anything?
You can do me a favor.
I did you a favor last night.
That guy calls? You tell him I'm on my way over and I'm very, 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 very pissed.
Hey, what about my 15 bucks?
Tell him you're pissed too. Trust people, you get screwed over every goddamn time. Oh, is that you? Yeah, it's about friggin' time.
Oh.
God, bad smog. Shit! Shit! Oh, damn it! Just great! Everywhere. I hate days that start like this. Damn it. Okay. Oh, damn it, damn it. What is this, trick-or-treat?
Come here.
What?
Come here.
Come here, your ass. Look, I don't know what your scene is, but don't do anything stupid, okay? No, you don't seem to understand. I've been trained to take care of myself, you know what I'm saying? I don't want to hurt you. Oh, shit. No!
We'll be right back.
Samantha? Doris?
Trying to do? Give me a heart attack?
Thought you were Doris. You know, she decked me last night, knocked one of my teeth loose even. Wait till Daddy hears about that. You know how he's always telling me to be careful with my mouth on account of the dental plan doesn't cover anything cosmetic. Ooh, anyway, get this. I think Chuck and Doris spent the night together last night. Wait till Daddy hears about that. I mean, even if he isn't pissed off about my mouth, which I can't imagine.
What's happening?
Oh, yeah, I guess you are a little confused. God, you look terrible. I ran away last night after she slugged me. Left a note and everything. But I didn't have any place to go, so I spent the night in the lawn storage shed. It's pretty gross with the snare all and everything. God, look at this kitchen. I'm not cleaning this up. So anyway, since I was still here this morning, I thought, hey, I'll go to pep squad practice and split after. So far, I don't know if pep squad practice is on or not. Can't get anybody on the phone.
Sammy, you can't get anybody on the phone because everybody's gone.
What? Did you have a mouthpiece?
I swear to God.
I didn't swallow my gum.
There's nobody. I mean, there's nobody.
Oh, right, nobody. I'm sure.
Come here.
Hey! Back off. Sweater cost $80. Muffy? Stupid dog.
Look! Look at this!
At what?
Doris isn't at Chuck's. I'll show you Doris. Here's Doris. This is all that's left of her, this and dust. Look! Here's Chuck. Where are the kids? It's Saturday morning. Where are the goddamn kids?
Not around.
Look, if you're trying to scare me, you're doing it, okay?
I'm not trying to scare you.
Then stop it.
I'm not doing it. You try calling someone. Not just your pep squad, anyone. Nobody's home.
Unbelievable. That's song number 16 on the survey this week. And don't forget, we preview the top 20 every Friday night. A great way to start a super weekend here in the Southland.
Get down.
Are you sure this is the radio station?
Yeah, just go on in.
Well, don't push.
Do you think whatever happened, happened everywhere? Like in Burbank or places like that?
Well, that's a DJ. He does the news, doesn't he?
Search me. I always change the channel when the news comes on.
Here's something in here.
Just found trouble. Trouble.
where is he?
I mean, somebody has to run this stuff, don't they?
We got trouble, not us. That's the name of the song, and I'm Steve LeBeau, trapped inside your radio, the guy who really cares about you. I mean, who else would sit in this little box every day just to play music for you? Well, it's time to reach into the old mailbag here. Got a letter from...
Beam me up, Scotty.
Close to high school.
Okay, girls, hold it right there. You, the blonde, get into the light.
Wait. Sounds like a great time. Got a fun. Why don't you just let my sister go, and maybe you and I can work something out.
I'm not going anywhere.
You got the wrong idea. You, into the light. I'll give it a five. One, two. No? All right, let's try it this way. Five, four, three.
Okay, okay. Do you get a lot of dates this way?
Open your eyes. Okay. Hey, I know what you're thinking, but...
That you're a cretin?
Sweetheart, you haven't seen those freaked out zombies running around here?
Yeah, I was jumped by one.
Well, you got off lucky. Me and this girl pulled into town this morning.
You don't work here?
No, I drive a truck. I was heading to San Diego with this girl I picked up. We were looking for a gas station. That's when we spotted one of those... whatever they are. Looked like it was eating... looked like it was eating a cat.
A dead cat?
Semi-dead.
Who'd want to eat a live cat?
Beats the shit out of me. This girl freaked out. Took off running. I spotted her about 20 minutes later. Looked like one of those things had...
What?
Torn her apart.
Oh, God. Larry.
Oh, shit.
What's with her?
I don't think she's gonna be sick or something. Guy she knew? Same thing might have happened. Is it safe around here, do you think?
Yeah. I checked it out.
Swell.
Are you all right? My name's Hector. What's yours?
Just leave me alone, okay?
Look, I know we got off on the wrong foot, but considering what the alternative is, I think we should try to get along. What do you say? Listen, this is no time for an attitude problem. Your little sister seems to be taking this a lot better than you.
That's because she doesn't know what's going on.
And you do, I suppose?
Whatever's going on isn't just here, it's everywhere. She thinks we're going to be rescued, that her dad's going to come back from Honduras with the goddamn green berets.
She could be right.
Give us a break, Hector. Where'd you spend the night last night?
I spent the night in the back of my truck with the girl I picked up. What else do you want to know?
Skip it. Steel's got to be the answer. If Sam spent the night in the lawn storage shed...
What?
Again, I'm an employee. I can't. Just our way of saying Merry Christmas to you from all of...
Testing. 1, 2, 3, 4. This
This is Samantha Belmont, one-third owner of the Greater Los Angeles Basin. Speaking. You guys?
Hey, is anybody there?
Where'd you get this, a dime store?
Beats me. It was given to me.
Yeah, well, it might be all right for date night in the barrio, but if we run into any more of those guys outside, we're gonna need a little more stopping power.
Date night in the barrio.
Now that you got everything that you wanted, you're gonna have to learn to deal with the dream.
And here's some other changes. Most of you guys had finals this week. Later. Their history, they're canceled. The legal drinking age is now 10, but you will need ID, let's be real. I'll be taking requests from all you teenage Comet zombies on the hit line. That's 555-4487. You get it? 555-HITS.
Do you know where the Armed Forces Reserve Center is at Los Alamitos?
Yeah.
My dad used to take us there for target practice. They store automatic weapons there.
You know how to use them?
Come on, Hector. Mac-10 submachine gun was practically designed for housewives. I got a call. It came in on the hit line. It went dead. Did they say they were okay?
I don't know.
They said they were in the desert.
The desert. What desert was it?
I don't know.
Shit! Think!
Why don't you just pull your gun on her? Maybe you can scare it out of her.
They said they were like part of a think tank or research group or something.
Where? Was it in this state?
I forget.
Okay, let's take it real slow. Did they mention a town? Someplace they were near, like maybe Blythe, Bishop?
What about Edwards Air Force?
If I knew, I'd tell you. I didn't expect the call, you know. I didn't take notes or something.
Just try.
You think I'm not telling you something on purpose?
Well, if they'll stay put, we can get them.
From a psychological standpoint, the radio station represents a link to normalcy. I don't think they'll wander far as long as it's operating.
Dr. Carter, I'd just like to say up front, I'm opposed to this. There's no reason for us to bring those people or any other survivors back here.
What about the disintegration factor? You just want to let that happen?
We don't know that the condition is progressive.
I think we've established that, Audrey. Partial protection seems to result in a slowing of the overall effect. But progression is steady in any case. Drying of the body fluids.
Oh, get to the point, Oscar.
Transition.
We've heard this a thousand times.
Ultimately.
What about the dust?
Ultimately, there is nothing left but calcium dust.
Right. So there isn't even enough hope to warrant bringing anybody back here.
So what you're saying is we shouldn't even try.
Right.
We don't want to be caught in the city after dark. We'll leave tomorrow. And we've had an indication of some survivors in San Bernardino as well.
Wait a
Four,
minute.
Maybe five.
Wait, girl, just shut up! Samantha! Say anything else. Anything!
Yeah? They said be careful on the street because some people were exposed to the comet a little bit. What happened to Doris is happening to them, only slower. And like, they're dangerous. Like what happened to Larry.
presents.
Oh, shit!
I know you guys are probably gonna give me a ticket or something, but I am really glad to see you.
Everything must go. Big savings on tuners, turntables, car stereos. Also demos and great damaged items. This weekend only, Henry Stereo Warehouse, 4th and Alameda. Free coffee for the adults, free balloons for the kids.
I know. I know.
Expand your career horizons. For a clearer view of
people, is there anything I can do?
Your future. It's interstate technology.
Fine.
Interstate Technologies is an equal opportunity employer. Looks like the weather is shaping up for a great weekend. You know, it's hard to believe that there's only 11 more shopping days till Christmas. Good luck finding a parking space within hitchhiking distance of the malls, too. You know how jammed it can get.
She okay?
Yeah. I guess so.
Come on in, have a seat. Listen, I have to go to San Diego tomorrow.
Why?
My mom, some friends, my sister.
But you know they're gone.
I know, but I still have to find out. I mean, you guys know for sure, but I don't know.
Do you have, like, a close family?
Yeah. Pretty close. You?
No, I don't know. My real mom hung around till my dad came back from Vietnam, then she split. So it's been mostly me and Sam, and Dad and Third Special Forces. Smoke Bomb Hill. Fort Bragg. But then around about the sixth or seventh grade, it became real obvious that we weren't boys, that we were never going to go to ranger school. So I guess Dad figured there was nothing more to offer us. So he found us a new mom and off looking for a war.
What about the guy, Larry?
Oh, he and I weren't going steady or anything like that.
to San Diego, okay?
I have to. But I'll be back.
Please, okay?
What'll you give me if I come back?
Texas?
Florida. Florida and Texas.
Florida, Texas, and Hawaii.
Hawaii? I want in Hawaii.
When I come back, I'll take you to dinner. Your choice.
Great. See, this is the problem with these things. Daddy would have gotten us Uzis.
The car didn't know the difference.
So, did you make it with him last night?
Who?
The good humor man. Who do you think?
Jesus, that was bugging you.
That's no answer, man.
No, I didn't make it with him last night. Why are you so weirded out?
Oh, right, Reg. Why should I be weirded out? My sister, who swiped every guy I ever had my eye on, has now swiped the last guy in the whole freaked out world.
Mother! Ma! I don't know who you are out there, but I have a gun. So if I were you, I'd split while I had a chance. Okay? Look, kid, just stay away. We don't want any.
Same creep.
Looking for you, I like kids. Jeez. There goes the neighborhood.
We found survivors. How long will the blood test take?
Not long.
I've talked with some of the others, and we decided that it would be more beneficial to conduct the blood tests in the field. So I want you to go to LA with the rest of the group.
Whatever the majority wants.
You don't seem to hold majority rule in very high regard.
If something's wrong, it's wrong. Majority rule doesn't have anything to do with it.
But it goes straight to the core purpose of our group, which is to survive. You'll grant me that.
The core purpose never included bringing outsiders to the facility.
About the 12th can you downed this morning.
Thirsty.
Yeah, well, what are you gonna do when your complexion freaks up? Dermatologist is dead, you know.
I know, and I'm getting a rash or something, too.
Oh, God, you and your rashes.
Hey, I'm sorry if the end of the world makes me a little nervous. So, do you like him?
Come on, Sam.
I'm just interested.
Yeah, well, I guess so. I mean, he's nice.
There was this new guy at school, Paul Morgan, and transferred from Taft, junior.
Oh, I don't hang around with juniors much.
I liked him. I mean, he was from Taft, but he was nice. Kathy said he was probably gonna ask me out. Kathy. She was flunking algebra and she was trying to figure out some way to keep her parents from finding out. This was a really lucky break for her. No wonder I'm breaking out. You think we could go home and change?
Look, why don't we get a little creative?
What?
Do you have your MasterCard on you?
No.
Good, because you don't need it. The stars are open!
like better? This? Or this?
The second one. Yeah, definitely.
How come?
Because it'll stay in style longer. Come on.
I guess you're right, actually.
Yeah, we gotta think of these things, you know?
Let's do it.
You know, I've been thinking.
Don't set any dangerous precedents.
What if Hector's got the same problem we have?
Such as?
Such as no guides.
What?
Really? I mean, what if Hector's gay?
I'm sure.
Think it over. You said he didn't come on to you last night.
So?
So that means that the last guy on Earth is either a gentleman or a fag. I mean, what are the odds? In L.A.? Things could be very interesting around here, Regina.
Attention, shoppers! I trust you've got credit cards to pay for all that stuff.
This one.
You dirty rat.
Get her, boys.
I think it's time to take the high ground.
Listen, you guys. We're expecting some friends here any minute. Look, you just split now, okay? And we'll tell them not to hurt you.
No imagination.
You're free and easy.
way. Ta-da!
Get her.
Knock that shit off. Hello out there in television land. All right, here's the deal. If Bachelorette number one isn't out here in half a tick, I'm gonna ice Bachelorette number two. Got it?
Come on. Let her go.
I'm sorry, miss. I can't have you holding one of my people hostage.
Even if you pull the trigger, I can still take him out. And you.
Come on, Willie. She means it.
Miss, you're not getting the point. I can't have you holding one of my people hostage. I'm not crazy, I just don't give a fuck.
What do you think, 20, 30 minutes?
No more.
They could be anywhere by now. Let's go back.
Let's apply a little deductive reasoning.
Deductive reasoning?
Where would adolescents with nothing to do go?
See, we worked really hard to get ahead in this business, girls. And we don't get shit for it! But we do it because we know we can work our way up through the system. And the system works. Why, just a few days ago, we were only stock boys. Now we own the store. The American way. And then this happens.
What are you talking about?
Well, I'm talking about you coming in here and ripping us off.
What do you want? You want us to pay for it? What?
You wouldn't believe what we want from you. In your worst nightmare, you wouldn't believe. Let's play a game. It's called Scary Noises.
This is the closest shopping arcade, but the whole area is an absolute monument to consumerism.
All we can do is hope. Check all the floors, including the basement.
Isn't that a scary noise? Want to hear it again? Gosh, the suspense is killing me. Let's do it again. An e-ticket attraction. Let's do it again. Now, wait a minute. I don't think there's really a bullet in here. No, now, see there? It's loaded. I just needed to be a little more patient. I think this is it, girls. I really do.
Guys, really, like we just met him an hour ago. I mean, look at this stuff that we have. Look at this
spirit. Well, it's ironic. Of all the great minds of the world, all the great intellects, who should survive? Or almost survive? I don't have to see the result of the blood test. I can guess what they say about that one.
You're right. It would be senseless to take her back. Look, I'll stay and take care of it. Then if this Hector person shows up, I can run tests on him too.
Of course, it would be out of the question to let you remain by yourself. I'll stay here with you.
Listen, thanks for suggesting that I wait for Hector. I mean, I know Reggie will probably get him, but I'd like to have a shot at it.
Samantha, I need you to lie down.
Hector's not exactly a fox, but considering what's left, he's not bad.
He sounds cute. Is he coming back?
Yeah. But we should wait for him at the radio station. That's where he'll go. What's that?
I'm gonna give you something.
For what?
Well, your skin's been a little irritated.
Yeah, a rash.
It could be a rash, but it could also be something else. It's one of the main symptoms of...
The comet? No. See, I always get rashes, like when I have a fight with Doris or I break up with a boyfriend. It's nerves, and you know, the way things have been going around here lately, I'm surprised I don't look like strawberry jello. But if I do have that stuff, this will get rid of it, right?
Yeah.
God, you had me worried.
Don't worry. Just a pinch now.
Ow! So you guys are like geniuses, right?
Yeah, I thought so.
We have a couple of geniuses at my school.
Yeah?
Yeah. They're both wimps.
Is that it?
What did you want me to do, Oscar? Take her out back and shoot her in the head?
I simply meant I was glad it was painless.
I don't think we have to stay around. She didn't think that he was coming back.
I feel we can wait. But, I feel the radio station is the more logical place.
Listen, Oscar, you were right about the condition being progressive, but it is also accelerating, apparently. We don't have weeks. We have maybe hours. I don't know.
We have a commitment.
But I do know I don't have enough to debate the issue. I am not going to be a party to taking anybody else back.
You have to live up to it.
What do you expect me to do, Oscar? Go for my gun?
Of course not.
Merry Christmas!
Reggie?
Disappointed lady, you better get up off your
Samantha.
Knees. No one said it'd be easy, babe. You got my sympathy.
Hi.
I know what you're
Hi.
Feeling. Yes, we've all been there before.
Do you happen to see two girls running around here? One's a cheerleader.
I'm not thinking straight. I wrote everything down, but I think I misspelled it. That pad on the table. You need this?
No, thanks. I have one.
Seems to be the perfect Christmas gift this year. I'm gonna miss Christmas. Permanently. I want you to know that I thought they were talking hypothetically until they found the first survivors. And they really did it. Some of those survivors were just kids.
Hey, wait a minute. What's all this about blood?
They think they can generate a serum.
A serum?
We were exposed. Not a lot, just enough. They left the ventilating ducts wide open. The fans going. Very scientific. Very stupid. In 36 hours, you will be able to vacuum up the last of them from the carpet.
Hey, you know what?
She was right. You are cute. Santa Claus.
Have you ever had hepatitis?
Darn tags. You have a pair of scissors?
No. Have you ever had hepatitis?
Cute kids. They part of you guys?
No. They're survivors just like you are.
Neat girl, huh?
If you like the type.
Come on, kids. Come with me.
Have you ever had hepatitis?
No. Had mono once, though. Caught it from this guy named Randy Sharp.
Anemia?
No.
Are you pregnant?
Nope. Thought I was once, though.
That's not important.
That's what you think. That's the longest 3 weeks of my life.
No, I can't remember. How much blood were we expected to get from these people?
300 cc's. Yes, that's it.
That can't be right. If we draw 300 cc's a day, they'll expire altogether.
No, I don't think so, now that we've terminated brain functions. I mean, they're brain dead. All they can do now is manufacture blood.
Well, maybe. But we aren't going to get anything like 300 cc's out of those children.
No, but we will out of that teenager. I hope she's just as healthy as she looks.
Boy. Did you see her hair? What I'd give to have hair like that.
What is this place?
Do you have diabetes?
I mean, is this some sort of, I don't know, underground hospital or what?
You're a very strong-willed young lady.
Cancer.
You have cancer?
No, I am a cancer. I just want to know where I am and what I'm doing here.
Oops. Oh, gosh. Could you hand me that arterial?
Got it. Well, it's up to the respirators now.
Why don't we prep the children? When we're finished with them, we can start on that girl.
They're so cute. I love working with kids.
Yeah. Oh, don't forget the lights.
Are you taking any medication? Have you had any medication within the last 24 hours?
Where's my sister?
Dr. Carter, may I see you a moment?
All right.
I mean, she should be here by now, shouldn't she, even if Hector didn't show up?
Your sister's dead.
What?
I realize this comes as a shock. But she had been exposed, and in 48 hours, she would have died anyway. It was quite painless, I can assure you.
My, you both have nice, strong hearts.
Are we gonna get shots?
No. No shots, I promise.
Audrey?
They're not back yet. Listen, we may have a situation on our hands here. I can't locate Rogers anyplace in the compound. We can't rule out the possibility that he may already have gone into transition.
We can't wait for Audrey. You're gonna have to start with the children and that one in there. We need blood to develop the serum.
We don't have enough for everyone.
We're not robots, Doctor. We're not all gonna fall over at one time. Some of us will last a little longer, while others of us have more immediate need. You're smart. You can figure that out. Psychology's not an exact science, but my God, man, anybody can answer it too.
I'm very sorry about your sister. It's a tragedy. It truly is. And I can understand your hostility, but no matter how upset you are, breaking an expensive piece of equipment won't solve anything. I mean, striking out at inanimate objects is really quite childish. Even you should be able to realize that.
Jerk.
Howdy, partner. How you doing?
Who are you?
Name's Heck. Heck Gomez. Hey, them's real fine duds you got there. You a Maytag repairman?
Did you find this place?
Well, this lady back in L.A. sent me. Hey, you been to L.A. lately? It's cleaned out, man, I'm telling you. Hey, come here, I want to show you something. Come on. Hey, you know how the Harbor Freeway is always bumper to bumper? Well, you can go 150 miles an hour if you want to. Me and this baby, we go through them freeways like turkey crap through a tin horn. Hey, y'all. You like girls? Look in here. She ain't dead. See, this lady shot her up with sodium pentothal to make this fella think she was dead. So you wouldn't suck her blood out, you asshole.
Son of a bitch!
Shit.
Excuse me, everyone. I'm afraid our adolescent guest has escaped. She's quite hostile.
We have already gone topside, so please, take a moment and look around you.
Check those rooms and I'll check those rooms.
Let's go.
Everything's under control.
Good.
Shots.
This isn't a shot, sweetheart. It'll just...
You'll just giggle, and then you'll feel a little sleepy.
That's right.
And when you wake up, do you know where you'll be?
Where?
With Santa Claus at the North Pole.
In fact, you'll live with Santa Claus for the rest of your life.
Hey, there's no such thing as Santa Claus.
What? You don't believe in Santa?
What are you guys doing?
They said if we breathe this, we could go to the North Pole and see Santa Claus.
That's so sick.
Hey! Ah! Holy shit!
Whoa. Sam?
I give.
They said you were dead.
They were exaggerating, totally.
Hey, that's a great outfit.
Thanks. Is that guy in the hallway dead?
Don't.
Well?
You can give up if you want to, Wilson. But we still have the two children and that girl.
I forgot my football.
We'll get you another football.
We'll get you a stadium. Now.
Get everybody outside. Now. What about them? Screw them.
Okay, kids. Going up.
Put your hands down, kids. God, don't be so stupid.
I'm Brian.
I'm Sarah.
Yeah, and I'm Aunt Rich. And that's Aunt Sam. That's Uncle Hector.
Can I have my bunny?
In a minute. Beat feet, Uncle Hector.
Uncle Hector?
Hey, it's my bunny, you know.
I met her on the highway. I picked her up outside of Portland town.
Where have you been? Can we change this?
Arranging a hot foot for your friends.
I really hate this music.
Give me a break.
What are you doing?
I'm not kidding. I get car sick without my bunny.
Come on, Marge, give the kid the bunny. We've stopped. Why have we stopped?
Son of a... Don't shoot them, you idiot.
Okay, kids, cover your eyes for Uncle Hector.
Hey! Think tank, huh?
Look, couldn't we just, like, leave?
Think over this!
We can get them.
Hey, we'll be taking off.
We have to get them.
Look at them chasing, so we're party down, huh?
Come on.
This is fun.
The kids would like to say goodbye. It's been fun. Hope to see you around real soon.
Is that gasoline I smell?
Wait, don't!
Okay, that's great.
Can I take this jacket off? It itches.
No, you can't. I just want to take another picture, all right?
Please?
No. No, you just hold on to that. Stay there. Okay, perfect.
Oh, brother. There's still a few zombies around.
Don't slouch. And Sarah? Hold that. Smile. Did the flash go off? I can't tell on these things.
Hey, if you're gonna throw those guns away, can I have one?
Don't look at me. I mean, I don't know where she gets that stuff. Smile, heck. Handsome.
Maybe I could be a nun or something.
Oh, I just love these pictures.
We've only taken about 30 of them.
You know, we're gonna need some more film.
Let me straighten your tie.
Okay.
Maybe
not more. God, they look like the Brady Bunch.
What are you waiting for?
Can I see him?
We're waiting for the light to change.
We do not cross against the light.
Are you nuts, Auntie Regina?
You may as well face the facts, Samantha. The whole burden of civilization has fallen upon us.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means we do not cross against the light.
That's totally stupid! There's nobody here! See? We're talking ghost town!
See what happens?
God, I'm sorry, but you shouldn't cross against the light like that. Hey, you guys are survivors too, huh? What?
Nothing. Great car.
Thanks. I have 23 of them. You want to go for a ride?
More than you know.
We don't know anything about this guy. Where's he from? What's his name?
What's your name?
Danny Mason Keener.
Danny Mason Keener, okay?
Yeah, all right. Well, just be back by midnight, okay?
Midnight?
The burden of civilization is on us, okay?
Oh, yeah.
Bitchin', isn't it?
Think that it's over, but you can't explain why. Waiting home, waiting for the phone to ring. But your spirits are dragging, and you're wandering aimlessly, trying to forget about how happy we used to be.